Turkey farmer Matt Curtis of Snyder County, Pennsylvania, is blazing a path. A path he admits hasn't been easy, but one he hopes other farmers will soon travel. You see, a number of factors made Curtis stop and evaluate his turkey operation, which is located within the Susquehanna Basin of the Chesapeake Bay watershed.
This is the brood section of the barn. These are where the young poults are starting.
He needed to get Windview Farm in line with federal mandates to clean up the bay.
These are little hens.
He also wanted to cut some of his operating costs by reducing his fossil fuel usage, and he wanted to make sure his flocks were as comfortable as possible during their stay with him.
Probably one of the most important factors in being successful in production livestock is to reach a high level of animal comfort.
So with his guests generating about 400 tons of litter per year and having to spend more than $30,000 for propane, Curtis quickly discovered the litter incinerator hot water boiler. Here's how it works. The bedding material, or litter that the birds are grown on, is stored until cold weather arrives. It is then brought to a hopper and automatically fed into a burner.
This is actually what's feeding material into the burner. There are three augers inside here that are all controlled by the computer, and it just pushes the material into the firebox.
The burner generates heat that's transferred to a water boiler.
This is our PEX tubing, which is a plastic tubing that we use, very flexible and durable.
The hot water moves underground to the turkey houses and to the heat exchangers inside to heat the baby birds.
Travel up the ceiling, they'll go down to the heat exchangers.
After going through the heat exchangers, the cold water returns to the boiler to be reheated.
How much litter does it take to keep the houses warm?
About 300 tons to heat 60,000 square feet.
While the system seemed like it would help Curtis reach his goals, he knew financial assistance was the only way to make it happen. He turned to grant writer Denise Bechtel with Penn State Outreach's Small Business Development Center.
He was awarded $156,000 for the project. The total project cost him about $218,000 for the cost of the burner. He has less than a 2-year return on his investment, and he's up and heating both of his poultry barns, and it's turning out to be a wonderful project.
Of course, along with grants comes the need for results, and that is what Penn State's Dr. Paul Patterson's team of colleagues and students are busy gathering.
When I'm here, I will collect manure samples, air samples, so I collect CO2, carbon dioxide, and ammonia levels in the houses to see what they compare against propane houses. And then I collect the ash samples and we take that back and we're looking to see what the ash does.
To be actually burning litter, brooding birds, reducing propane use and growing good quality birds and seeing them benefit from this environment is really exciting. And now that we have the ash in our hands, it looks very promising for recycling that phosphate as both a fertilizer and a feed phosphate. So it's exciting to be working on this project.
And exciting for his students as well.
It's really opening my eyes to see the different sides of animal science that I can work with.
And while data continues to be collected at Windview Farm and promising results continue to emerge, a new goal for this group is to spread the word.
I think there's real potential for other growers to save money and to recycle these phosphates in sensitive watersheds, and then do this in a collective way and have a real market outlet for it as well.
If there's a grant out there that can help a farmer, not only on biomass, but energy efficiency, wind, solar, any type of project, energy management, if it's a USDA grant, a US funded grant, or a state funded grant, I can help farmers, small businesses apply for those types of grants.
Very optimistic as far as our end results, and everything looks really, really good. At this point, I'm really happy.
For Penn State Outreach, I'm Jamie Carrott.